Please welcome this week's special guest, Ben. Richard, what is Ben to you?
This is Ben, and I once convinced him that he'd been spooked by a ghost in a country house.
Sean, how do you know Ben?
Well, this is Ben, and I had to talk to him for over an hour to keep him calm when he got trapped in a portaloo.
David, what's your relationship with Ben?
This is Ben, and he very recently took me to my first ever football match. And was disappointed that I nodded off for a bit in the second half.
Lee's team, where do you want to start?
Well, first of all, Sean, how was he trapped in a portaloo?
Well, it was the lock wouldn't work, wouldn't open.
But why was it such a tense situation that you had to calm him down? Why is he panicking?
Because Ben, as I saw you, you'll notice that. I mean, you just have to look at him to know he suffers from a lot of anxieties. I mean, he looks so comfortable here, doesn't he? Just so relaxed under all these lights. He's not. Inside, he's...
Where was the portaloo?
On a campsite.
Had you met him before?
I'd seen him on the campsite.
And he'd nodded. Hello.
Oh, yeah. Right. Well, you know what it's like. You walk across a campsite and you've got a toilet roll in your hand. Everyone knows, you know, where you're going. They sort of smile at you, so where you... It's like... We've all been there. We've all been there. And you're walking across, and you've got a toilet roll, and people go, "All right, yeah."
And they go,
"What again?" And then they got that "what again" look without saying it.
So, did you go to use the portaloo?
No, I was going out of the campsite.
And you heard? What did you hear?
Well, someone sort of struggling with the mechanism.
Oh, no shouting at this point.
If someone, you know, it's a matter of politeness. If someone's making sort of struggling noises in a portaloo, you don't think you can do much to help. I like to think, yeah. And even if I could, I don't really want to get involved in that problem. But as I was walking out, I thought, it looks like it was wobbling slightly. And I went back, I said, "Are you all right?" And he went, "No, I'm not."
And you talked to him for, you said, an hour?
Yes, yeah, we just...
Well, I'm curious to know what you filled an hour with.
Well, I was chatting about how his camping weekend was going.
Well, not very well.
Yeah. So you're in the thing with him, and eventually what happened? What was the outcome?
Yeah, how did he get out?
The guy came.
He died in the
campsite manager.
And then when he came out, you obviously the first time you'd seen each other.
Yeah.
And how was that? Did you fall in love?
I'll be honest with you, I think he was a bit disappointed. It was like a blind date.
Now, who else would you like to quiz, Lee?
Richard, could you remind us again, please, of your...
I once persuaded Ben that he'd been spooked by a ghost in a country house.
And what was the story? How did you convince him?
Well, he was in a separate room, and I saw, like, a stool... and realise, hang on, I can hit the rafters, knowing where he was, that'll sound like footsteps coming towards him. So I did, and he believed it was a ghost.
Yeah, what were you doing in this house? Is this just, like, an empty house where people are...
No, we worked together in radio.
Yeah.
And we were doing a ghost hunt.
Why was Ben in the room by himself?
Because he just wanted to be brave and go off, and he'd sat in the scariest, supposedly most haunted room in the house, which happened to be directly above where I was in the hall.
And how high were the ceilings in the room that you were in?
Fairly high, not massively high.
Well, how high?
If you think of me plus a chair, about that high.
That's a fairly low ceiling.
Oh, give up!
No, it is!
Really?
I am 6 foot.
All if right, I go, all right.
I'm just
we
saying,
got it.
I'm 6 foot and it's great.
Is it?
How did Ben react when you were making these noises?
Well,
did it spook him?
Yeah. He ran straight out through the door, which would have been running through where the ghost was.
Oh, well, so he properly panicked.
Oh, God, absolutely terrified.
Did he? Yeah.
Well, I know that about Ben. He does get very, very spooked. Anything like that freaks him right out.
Thank goodness he could open the lock on that door,
yes.
You know. When did he find out that it had all been a wheeze?
I told him About 10 years later.
10 years?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You've let him live with this trauma for 10 years?
No. Look at it this way, and I explained it to him like this at the time, because he was quite cross, because he would be. And I said, no, listen, you've dined out on that story. I know you have. You'd have told people at dinner parties, oh, yeah. The most haunted house.
Like people saying Nelson Mandela once rang me up.
David, remind us again, please.
This is Ben, and he took me to my first ever football match and then was disappointed when I dozed off for a bit in the second half.
When was this?
This was last season.
Oh, he's already got all the words, hasn't he? He has been training for this one.
I thought last season. Yeah.
What was the match?
It was association football. And it was between Tottenham Hotspur and Hull.
And who won?
Tottenham Hotspur.
How do you know?
I went to it.
And where was it played, in Tottenham or at Hull?
In Tottenham.
Do you remember the name of the ground?
What if I could? Would that make this definitely true?
I'm not willing to say how I feel about that. Okay. Until you say it.
I'm not willing to say how I feel about anything, but that's just because I'm British. Yes, it was at White Hart Lane. Thank you. Yes, I do have a research team.
Do you remember the colour of the kits?
Let's say one team was in white and the other team wasn't.
What colour was the goalkeeper wearing?
Green. All over, with a little tricorn hat. as I recall.
So, how do you know Ben?
He was at school with me.
OK, and if you don't like football, why would you have gone?
I'm an idiot. I was about to say, I like to experience new things. No, I don't. But occasionally, I get bullied into experiencing new things under peer pressure. He said, you're always slagging off football. Why don't you come along and the atmosphere will be great, you might quite like it, and then maybe, just maybe, you'll shut up for a bit.
Who are you there to support?
Well, vaguely. He's a Spurs fan. That's the shortening. Nice. I was broadly, you know, hoping his team would win.
Do you remember the score?
I think there was one goal.
Well, to the Tottenham Hotspurs?
Exactly, and it was on the basis of that that the victory was declared to be theirs.
Back to you in the studio.
So, Lee's team is Ben, Richard's frightened friend, Sean's Portaloo pal, or David's matchday mate?
I don't see Sean chatting to somebody trapped in a Portaloo. He doesn't strike me without laughing. Like
yeah, it's true, isn't it? That is a very good point. I've known Sean long enough to know he would be going, oh, come on, everyone, let's push it over.
Richard and the roof is where he lost me. Just the height.
Yeah, that's the height. It's too high for you.
No, just also, like, to exert enough force to hear it through the roof with your... Like, maybe you would have barely touched them, but then your height... When we looked, no.
I think they're saying that in a stately home, any person, however tall, plus a stool, they're doubting. It's not just you.
Oh, no, it's just him.
He said that like he was a Spanish ambassador and he was worried about being insulted. Yeah. I think, ambassador, it's any person. It's nothing to do with your height, sir.
No, not Richard.
What about David in the football?
Well, it is possible that he would have a friend, I suppose.
So what are you going to say?
I suppose we're left with David, are we?
Yeah.
OK.
You think it's David. Right, Ben. Would you please reveal your true identity?
My name is Ben, and Richard spooked me by pretending to be a ghost in a country house.
Really sorry, mate. Really sorry about that.
Thank you very much, Ben.